Union activists at the Montebello summit this week in Quebec are accusing police of being wolves in sheep's clothing, and they say they have the proof.
The authorities at Montebello were planted agents, provocateurs, that were amongst the legitimate protesters during the Three Amigos summit.
They claim this footage shows three undercover police agents, the three men whose faces are covered with bandanas, trying to provoke violent confrontations. Protesters suspect the masked men were members of the Quebec police force and accuse the three of deliberately trying to provoke a riot to give uniformed officers an excuse to arrest the group. The masked men were indeed arrested. Their identities are not known. Quebec police aren't commenting on the accusations. Joining me now is Maude Barlow, the National Chair of the Council of Canadians, Canada's largest citizens advocacy group. So why do you think police would want to do this?
Well, it was very clear that the police on the side street that was assembling behind a very peaceful sit-in wanted to get down the street to block in people, protesters at the other street that were up near Montebello, and they would have then been blocked in because it was a graveyard on one side, and which was filled with police, and then another police line up here, and then the Montebello fence here. But they had no provocation because it was about two dozen quiet protesters just sitting there, a bunch of us, and a number of us were standing around just kind of protecting them, but the police kept inching up, and they were getting very close. Suddenly we started seeing some of them take out those plastic wrist, you know, handcuffs, as if they were going to start doing something, but there was no provocation, and all of a sudden these three guys came rushing up and being very threatening and big. And there were protesters, real protesters, chasing them, saying they're police, they're provocateurs, stop them. And one of them, at least one that we saw, had a big brick, a rock in his hand, and was clearly there to agitate. And we believe that they did it so that the police would have an excuse to then march in and remove the peaceful protesters and then take the street, which is what they wanted to do.
But here's the part that I don't get. If the protest was peaceful, why would they want to arrest anyone there?
Well, if you look at the big picture, the idea was to discredit all opposition to the Security and Prosperity Partnership. The Prime Minister Harper and President Bush joked about how silly we all were and that we're aliens and so on, worrying about aliens from other planets. They joked about you know, jelly beans being the real issue here, so we've dubbed it the Jelly Bean Summit. And they've started calling us the radical left or radical protesters or the loony left or whatever, just ad hominem names. And it would fit in with that whole concept if we could just show that the protesters were few, and many of the government reports certainly underrepresented the numbers that were there, but that we were violent, which was by and large not the case. There may have been some conflicts, but it was very contained, very small, 99.99%. of the demonstration was peaceful. So if you can destabilize that and make it look like something else, then you have discredited us, you've allowed the police to move in to block the protesters they were considering a little more likely to move into direct action, and you buy into this whole notion that we're not serious people and you can just joke about jelly beans and space aliens and not take our concerns seriously.
Now, we only have about 30 seconds left, but where does all of this go from here? Quebec police aren't saying anything.
Well, there is very damning evidence, and we have evidence, and you'll see it in the video, that the shoes that the so-called protester was wearing was exactly identical to the shoes of the people so-called arresting them. There has been no confirmation they've been arrested. We want to know who they are. We want to know if they were arrested. We want their names. We know who was arrested genuinely, and we can compare. If these people are activists, why aren't their families asking where they are? They were taken very, very gently, I can tell you, led very gently into police wagons. They would not have been treated like that if they were true protesters. Believe me, it was almost embarrassing to watch the process take place. So we are demanding answers. I think it discredits the entire summit to see this kind of behavior on the part of those supposedly there to protect all of us.
All right, Maude Barlow, thanks very much.
Pleasure.